Okay, here we go. This is a long, well, it's not a long weekend, but it was a quick trip up to the farm on this fine Friday, but now it's threatening rain. But here we go with this September, the end of September, and I haven't done a regular video like this in a long time. And Monty and I were talking about it, and we said, you know what, let's just do one of our good old videos without all the music and stuff. So this will be our weekend. So there's my girl, and we're getting ready to get on Palmer Bridge Road and head on up to the cabin. Okay, see ya. Looks like we got some weather moving in. Awfully dark skies, but we made it. So here we are at the cabin, Mari and Quinta, for the weekend, huh? So let's do our routine. Let's cut the power on and let's get the keys and get everything unlocked, and we'll bring it to you. Okay, once I get the keys, I have to go unlock everything and get everything unpacked, get everything loaded, and I don't know, 30 minutes. Get the air conditioner running, you know, get the ice maker going, get the hot water turned on, and we'll be settling in. So I tell you, this has been a crazy week. And Monty and I have made some new friends, so I'm happy for her. And we decided to come up here for the weekend and relax. So air conditioned time, put that puppy down to 70, get some lights going, and welcome to the cabin, people. Let the weekend begin. So we've made it. Everything now is unpacked. It is hot. I broke out in a sweat, and but it's really overcast. There's like no sun whatsoever, so it's kind of cooling off. Got the fan up there going right there, and the air conditioner is on. So on our way up here, well, new developments. So Monty's here, for those of you who don't know, and we have been coming up here pretty regularly. We've had a couple of weekends where it was either rain or she decided to go shopping with my mom. But overall, we've been coming up here. And it's always to do something on a Saturday. Not necessarily Marty and I, but my dad and I. So we're starting the new addition to the tractor shed, which is going to be an enclosed workshop, so to speak. And a 5 feet wide swath of it's going to be a new bathroom that we are going to put in and take the bathroom, the toilet, out of the cabin and kind of expand a little bit more space. So anyhow, Dad's coming up tomorrow. We've got all the lumber to frame all the walls and the doors and windows and stuff, and I think we're going to get that done tomorrow. So we've been up here feeding the deer. We've been up here working with the grass, with all the trails that I cut with the bush hog, and sprayed last weekend with, I think it was 25 gallons of Roundup that I went all on the trails in front of the cabin and then the entire road from property line to property line and ditches. I sprayed all of that. So we've cooked some good meals. Everything up here is set and good to go, and my baby and I are settling in nicely. Tomorrow will be her 90-day mark. So if you remember past videos, once Mari's visa was stamped, as arriving in the United States on a K-1 visa, she had 90 days, we had 90 days to get married. So tomorrow is the 90th day. With that being said, this past Monday, Maddie and I, in the previous video, went down to the Charleston County Courthouse on Broad Street and got married. So it's official. We are now married, and we are moving to the next step, which will be what they call a change of status. We are going to change Maddie to an American here in the United States permanently, and she will get her green card. Now, also this week, Maddie has met a new friend. Her name is Amanda, and she is from Brazil as well. I think she said she's been here 8 years. They live in our neighborhood, her and her husband. So she came over the other night for dinner, and we had a great conversation because she speaks fluent English, and that was really good. So that has opened up a door that's going to lead to many doors of Maddie making friends and being able to communicate with somebody, on top of getting just into the swing. You know, we talked on the way up here about her getting a car. She's got some money, and she's ready to possibly get her a used car. So she's ready to start venturing out and learn her way around, and I'm really excited about that. So anyhow, I've brought up leftovers from the house, and we are going to heat those up and have a dinner tonight. I brought a couple of pears, and we're going to eat those. And I brought the Amazon Fire Stick because I got the Wi-Fi up here now, which is a new development. I now have access to the outside world, which I don't know if that's a good thing, but it is very handy when it comes to the Fire Stick and renting movies when we're inside getting ready for bed. So anyhow, we'll see what tonight brings, okay? Peace out. One more thing. Since this is official now, we decided to put our flags out just for the hell of it, because it's something we did a while back. So Maddie has her Brazilian flag that she can't reach. Oh, more desculpa. Okay, so we have the Brazilian flag on one side of the cabin, and on this side, you know, old red, white, and blue, old glory. So the fountain's going, even though we've had a lot of rain up here, which according to the rain gauge, it's not a lot, but you can tell by the roads. I'm running the fountain to pump out the well, get all that, I hate to say stagnant water, but just, it's full of iron and extremely, I want to say rich in iron. But if I let that well run for a while in the pond, when I take a shower or get water out of the faucet or whatever, it's quite decent actually. So anyhow. Deer are fed, birds are fed, hummingbirds are still buzzing around, their feeders are still full, a bunch of them's already cut out, and we are going to start our evening. I stopped by the liquor store and bought a bottle of Patui, which is this stuff right here. God, I haven't talked to y'all in a while, so there's a lot of good stuff going on. This stuff right here is a product of Brazil. It's imported from Brazil, and this is made with sugarcane. So it's, best way to describe it is a cross between vodka and tequila, but it makes what we call, or they call in Brazil, caipirinha, which is the national drink, and it is amazing. And I'll make one tonight, and you will see it, okay? Peace. Sitting here, we had some early visitors, so check this out. so tenderly. Away they went. Pew. I'm gonna come out here and cut the light on before all of them come out, and then I have to run them all off to come out here to cut the light on. So it's a sacrifice you gotta make. They'll be back though. Plenty of corn out. They can't stand it. So here we go. Ready? Yeah. Okay. That's that. So, as usual, it's too dark. These videos don't do well. However, I did cook leftovers and some Uncle Ben's rice, so we're getting ready to have dinner. So, here's my girl up there on the front porch. I don't know if you can see her. It's been quiet, but all of a sudden a deer came out. Kind of like that one weekend when it was like nothing stirring. But we'll see what tonight brings. Okay, so I just had my shower. Monty and I had a great dinner, and it was leftovers, but it was good. It was the dinner she cooked the other night when Amanda came over to the house. Some Brazilian chicken and cream, and oh man, it was good. So anyhow, I wanted to show you the new ice machine because it is pretty damn cool, so stand by. So this is it. This is a small microwave, so you get an idea of how big this is. And this is what it makes all day long. Off of a, maybe not even a gallon of water, it'll run until probably Sunday morning, making ice the whole time. So I am in the process of filling up my cup with ice. I just took a shower, so I'm using my hands, but it does come with a little ice scoop. Pretty cool. Anyhow, it drops ice every 7 minutes, a dozen cubes. So pretty cool little device here, and you can make big cubes, little cubes, and it'll stop when it's full, and it tells you when it's low on water. For $80 at Lowe's Home Improvement, people, I suggest you go get one. Well, good morning. It was an amazing night's sleep last night. Monty and I managed to watch a movie, but I think we fell asleep in between. Or I watched most of it, but yeah, I fell asleep. Anyhow, woke up at 4:30 this morning, like ready to go. Managed to fall back asleep, but it's 6:30 now, so I'm up. Got my pot of coffee going, and I just went and cut the spotlight off in the fountain. And we'll see if somebody shows up this morning to pay us a visit. Dad should be here at 8:30. We're going to eat breakfast, and then we're going to get to work. So we'll see what that brings us, okay? So, good morning. Yeah, they like to keep them curtains closed now. What happened? Good morning. Hey. Yeah, this one is ball on you. You want to sit? I don't know. You don't want to sit next to that, I know, right? All right, let's go down. Right. I don't care. So here we go, putting up the first wall of the new shed and bathroom. So floor's in, done. The toilet's marked. There's the first wall. and we're rolling with it.
Thank you. Being the experienced carpenters we are, I'm guessing this is the way to do it. It's pretty low.
Alright.
So,
so we've managed to get the back wall switched to the front wall. Because of a design flaw. Oh yeah, Ma. So we're framing in the door now for the bathroom. All right, Dad just left. Matter of fact, he's rolling out the driveway right now. So the rain came and got us. Oh my God, look at this hair. I'll tell you right now, I have been sweating my butt off. So this has been raining. It's raining right now. I don't know if you can see it in the video, but the rain caught us and we said, okay, that's enough. We managed to get all the tools put up before the rain hit. So this is where we got with the shed. So we got the back wall up, which we gave it a 6 or 8 inch slope, and the front wall. So there's the door. We got it framed in for the bathroom, which is going to be 4 feet wide. And then there's the rest of the shed, or Dad's talking about a bunkhouse now. I'm like, okay. Anyhow, I want to, on this wall right here, which will be the bathroom wall, I want to put a big window so you can overlook these woods right here and clean all this mess up right here. So anyhow, I am totally exhausted. My legs, my feet, everything hurts. So I think I'm fat, but I lose some weight, that'll take care of that. It's raining, so Marty and I, Dad picked up the table and brought from the house. It was sitting on the front doorstep from Amazon, Marty's massage table. So we got it up here. We'll probably put it together. And I'm going to take a quick hot shower and cool off, because I'm still just overheated somewhat. This rain and feels good with this overcast. But we're going to chill out for the rest of the afternoon, because I don't know if this rain's here to stay. I don't care if it is or not. So I say let's bring it. Oi, Amo! I inhaled a chicken breast that Marty had cooked for our chicken salads, and I brought them up here just in case, because I didn't feel like going to the grocery store. This is what we're dealing with, people. Yes, it is thundering, lightning, and raining since 3 o'clock. My beautiful wife, just the top of her head, right there, eating Doritos. Oh my God, we are so hungry. We had a beautiful breakfast early, but we didn't have any lunch. So anyhow, I think we're gonna go inside and chill out and watch a movie, because there's nothing else to do. So, peace. So Monty and I were just getting ready to settle down after she's giving me all this crap about the word the, or the letters TH, and how I say them really funny. And we look out the window and there's all these turkeys in the pouring down rain eating all the leftover corn from last night. Which is good. God, you know, it's the sad part about this is I don't know if these are what's left of that flock of 15 that I caught at one time. I think this might be a different flock, but they're all Jakes. And one is sitting there too busy chasing a crow away. So anyhow, we got some turkeys, deer and turkeys. Okay, so good morning. It's actually not morning, it's afternoon. It's 7:30 in the afternoon. So the last time I talked to you, Madi and I were laying down just to chill out for a little bit. And guess what? It rained. The sun came out. The turkeys came out. The deer came out. We slept. We've woken up. And now I'm trying to scramble to get the grill going and get dinner going because it's getting ready to rain again. So there's thunder off in the distance. The clouds are getting dark and black. Light here, light over there. But it's thundering like crazy over there. And last time that's where the storm came from. I'm hoping it misses us. So anyhow, we're cleaning up, straightening up just from this afternoon. And then we're going to start eating and drinking. So we'll see what I bring you. Back in the cabin. It is, I don't even know what time it is. I'll tell you what time it is. It's time to stay in the cabin because I've had enough. It's 9 o'clock. So Madi and I cooked sirloin steaks. She's back there shuffling Uno cards. We cooked sirloin steaks, little ones, which were actually very tender to my surprise. Big old baked potato with sour cream, butter, salt and pepper. It was amazing. And you didn't get any of that, so sorry. In the process of doing all this, we had a big old rat snake right by the shower on the ground, scurrying around, and is up under the deck somewhere, I'm sure, because it's pouring down rain again. So the mosquitoes, for some reason, have gotten really terrible. And we decided, you know what, let's just come in and play cards. So we're inside. The light's on way down there on the driveway. But I don't think any deer is going to come out because it's raining, and we're just going to see what tonight brings, okay? It is Sunday morning, and good night's sleep. It rained all night. No deer, and the only visitor we had was a rat snake. Big rat snake at that. Kind of got Madi a little freaked out, but she's okay now. Now that it's daylight and we can see everybody. So I just put on a griddle of bacon, and we're going to have some bacon and eggs for breakfast. And then I think we're going to suit up and take a little walk. And to my surprise, which I haven't looked to see what the temperature is, but it is cold. I have a long sleeve shirt on. And it is August 20-something. I don't even know what today is. I'm sitting here looking at Madi's telephone to see if I can find a calendar on her new Hello Moto telephone. Ah, today's the 25th. So August 25th, deer season has begun, and Dad has yet to go hunting, which surprised me. He says it's too hot. But anyhow, I want to take a walk and cruise the trails and see how the Roundup did after I sprayed. It's been 2 weeks now, I think. Anyhow, what a beautiful morning, though. It's overcast, and now it's actually windy. So anyhow, we'll bring it to you, okay? All right, here we are. It is 11:15, very busy morning. So we've cleaned up all of our mess from yesterday under the tractor shed. Marty is taking a shower as we speak. Rain again all night last night, so the flags were wet, but they are actually hanging and drying very well now. So I can wrap them up and put them away. All the dishes are done, the cabin is clean and organized, and Marty's trying to get in the cabin. So go ahead, Amal. Okay. And it's been windy. It's actually starting to warm up now, though, because it was 68 degrees, according to the little telltale thermometer this morning. 68. That's amazing. But it's very comfortable now. The wind is actually lying down, too. I want to take a walk. I want to go walk the paths where we sprayed to see how that looked. And we're probably going to just finish tidying up and we'll be out of here. Head on to the house, enjoy the rest of our Sunday, doing whatever it is we want to do. Good weekend other than the rain, but we got a lot accomplished on the new tractor shed as far as the garage. I'm excited. Got to get the roof on it now, get the side paneling on it. Get a window. Taking Friday off, so I think Friday Marty and I are going to go look around at Habitat or somewhere and try to find a nice window so we can frame in there. I'm just hung up on a window. I want a window in the bathroom instead of being in a box. You can sit there and look out into the woods while you do your thing. Oh, man. I tell you. You just can't beat this place. So I will talk to you guys soon. I still want to take a walk and see what Marty says. If we do, we're going to have to put on mosquito spray because the mosquitoes are horrible right now. And she just took a bath, so maybe not. But I'll talk to you in a minute, okay? Peace out. These guys must see something. Not sure what they're looking for. But it's cruising around. Sun just came out. Oh, wow. First time I've seen the sun since, Friday, I guess. So Marty's on the front porch talking to her mom. It's steady jabbering away, which is awesome. I'll tell you, technology nowadays brings everybody so close. Well, I guess the only thing we got to do now is just pack up and go home. I just don't want to. That's my next biggest decision. But I think it might be time. So weekend was good. It was very relaxing and productive. Got the new room going here on the far side of the tractor shed. So that's going to be great. It's going to be our bathroom. And Dad's talking about sleeping quarters now. I'm like, yeah. I don't know about all that. He needs to bunk up right here in his cabin. I move on to another project. But we'll see. Anyhow, later. Pack. And we're heading to the house. 2 days at the farm. And you know the sad part about it is I hate to leave. But it is what it is, I guess. So we're going to go ahead and lock this gate until I see it again, which might be next weekend, which I don't think I don't know what next weekend's going to bring, because Alyssa is supposed to come into town with Carrie. And if that's the case, they have a long weekend, just like I have a long weekend. I have 4 days off, starting Friday. And, I don't know. I still might be able to make it up here. Block this lock. And I need two hands to do it. Okay. Locked. Let's carry this thing to the house. Until next time.
And you think love is to pray, but I'm sorry.